As Europeans settled in the New World during the colonization of the Americas, they brought their music and musical instruments with them. Guitars and vihuelas, carried by Spaniards and Portuguese, were soon adopted and adapted by indigenous groups, giving birth to the new music and new musical instruments, such as the charango, the cuatro, and the jarana. All of these instruments share several characteristics, like their size, construction techniques, number of strings, and even tuning. In Mexico, an example of this is the jarana jarocha, a stringed instrument still played today in the state of Veracruz, near the Gulf of Mexico. Traditionally, their body is carved out of one single piece of solid wood. They are played with a strumming technique. Their stringing is quite particular. The first and the last strings are single and they're tuned to the same note. And the other six are arranged in courses or pairs of strings that are played together. Jaranas are usually divided in five different sizes to form what we call a family. This instrument here, it's a jarana primera, and it's right in the middle of the family, size-wise. It was made in the state of Veracruz by Carlos Escribano, using traditional construction methods. His work tools are limited to a handful of hand tools. He doesn't use rulers, power tools, sandpaper, or varnish. Though most modern makers have adapted the construction techniques to produce more refined instruments with more stable tuning, so they can be played with other instruments. But structurally, jaranas are still pretty much the same. The machete, also known as braguinha or cavaquinho, is a Portuguese instrument. It was brought to the Americas in the 16th century. In the northern areas of Latin America and in the West Indies, it also became known as the cuatro. It was widely adopted in Brazil, with the ghost string replaced with metal strings, and is still one of the most popular instruments in the country today. In the 19th century, the machete was brought to Hawaii by men from Madeira, an island off the coast of Portugal, who came to work on the sugar plantations. It was swiftly adopted by the Hawaiians, who called the instruments ukulele, which translates to jumping flea. The instrument became so popular that even the reigning monarch at the time learned how to play it. By 1900, the sound of the ukulele was pretty much ubiquitous across the islands. In Hawaii, the ukulele was subject to a number of changes. Makers started using native materials like the beautiful koa wood, and the body became much wider and deeper. A new repertoire emerged. At the beginning of the 20th century, Hawaiian performers brought their ukuleles to America, performing at the World's Fair and vaudeville acts. The visitors who attended the Panama Pacific International Exposition in San Francisco in 1915 absolutely loved Hawaiian music and the ukulele. The instrument became incredibly popular throughout the United States, and this didn't subside until the Great Depression. Nowadays, the ukulele is making a comeback, and it has become very popular again. Its size makes it very portable, it's economical, and the basic chords are relatively easy to play. What's not to like?